I think I'm going to be a uniter in Connecticut and in the country.
That was J.T. Lewis, the now 19-year-old brother of Jesse Lewis, a victim of the Sandy Hook tragedy. He's now running for state senate in Connecticut.
Yeah, he's hoping to make our schools safer here in our state. We're joined by him right now. J.T., good morning. Hey. We're so glad you're with us.
Thanks for having me.
Obviously, a very busy week for you.
For sure, yeah.
Yeah, you've been making the stops all over.
Yeah.
Have to ask you, first off, a lot of people watching, they say, he's only 19.
Yeah.
You know, what's your first response to that?
Yeah, well, I had this comment a lot, and I covered
it.
I covered it in my announcement video pretty well. I think after the shooting, when I was 12 years old, orphan genocide survivors from Rwanda reached out to me, and this is in a very dark place. You know, I'm 12 years old, just lost my brother, hadn't even gone back to school, and basically their message was, and these are people who had lost their entire families. Their message was, you'd be happy again. And so to reach back out to them, because they helped me through such a dark time, I wanted to raise money to send them to college, a couple of them to college. So after a month of fundraising, I went back to school. This kind of gave me a mission. I went back to school and started raising money. And after a month, I was able to send Betty, the original Skyper, to college for a year and pay for her family. She took care of eight younger siblings. And then it kind of turned into a much bigger thing. We were able to fundraise the rest of her 4 years total. We sent Matthew to college. We started helping Ugandan former child soldiers build fish ponds and poultry farms, self-sustaining, so that they could survive. And it's turned into a big thing. We've helped kids in Connecticut, you know, car crash victims who have left children behind. We've helped them. So it turned into this big thing, and raised and donated $35,000. So when people tell me I can't lead, I just throw that in their face, and you know, this is what I've already done at age 12.
Okay, as far as your platform here, greater school security seems to be the cornerstone of that. And I would say, tell me if I'm wrong, the focus that you're looking at is armed guards in schools. Would that be correct?
Well, it's one of the components of it. Obviously, mental health is a huge deal.
Yeah.
And my mom started the Jesse Lewis Choose Love movement. I'm actually interning with it this summer, part of what I'm doing this summer, obviously running for state senate too. And
if you're not busy.
There's a couple things going on.
Yeah.
And so that's a social emotional learning in schools. And there was a report after the shooting that said there's a couple things we can do to keep schools safe. And social emotional learning is one of the main components, and also gun control, other things that aren't going to happen overnight. You know, something we need to work towards, but aren't going to happen overnight. So, you know, we're working on that. It's over a million kids now, 50 states, 68 countries. So that's a huge part of it. And after Parkland is when I started getting involved in the school safety movement. I wanted to see something get done. You know, those kids had just lost family and friends, and they started to go down this gun control road. And that's a noble cause, but it isn't going to get done overnight. And I want to do something today to stop the shooting that's going to happen tomorrow. That was kind of my motto. And so we started, you know, the school safety movement, which is armed guards in part. And, you know, 6 months later, we were in the Oval Office, you know, releasing the most comprehensive school safety report in history with the president. So, yeah, I know how to lead. You know, this is stuff I can do.
Now, other than school safety, what other issues and policies would you advocate for if elected?
Yeah, well, when I'm elected, part of it will be education. It's a big part for me. Mainly because I just graduated high school. You know, I just went through the public school system in my district, and I think I can take that information, you know, the knowledge I had, the things as a student, and as my friends, you know, learned, the stuff that we want to change and make better, to make it a more efficient process and, you know, better for the kids, better learning, you know.
Yeah. Well, what specifically? I mean, what could you do legislatively?
Yeah, well, so that's something we're going to definitely look at, but, you know, having connections with superintendent, stuff like that, who reached out to me recently, just having connections with everyone, because I was just there. I graduated a semester early, but I was just there. But there's something I want to look at. Yeah, there's a lot of different things I want to do, but I want to get, before I start, you know, telling what, you know, the superintendent should do, I want to, you know, have a conversation with them, of course.
Yeah.
But there's a lot that we can do to make our public schools run better in my district and Connecticut.
We're glad you're here. We're, of course, going to follow your road. You've got a long road ahead. Election is until about a year from now.
Yeah, I'm primarying my opponent, so that's in August.
And then the final election, of course, in November.
Yes.
November. Well, we certainly wish you good. It's good to see that you're trying to strike a note of bipartisanship.
Yeah.
I mean, if there's nothing that...
I for sure am. You know, I just want to say, my brother Jesse, when he was killed, he was actually known as a hero because he saved 9 of his classmates. He told them to run, and so he's credited with saving 9 lives. And I kind of use that bipartisan message, but because we told that story to President Obama and President Trump, and they both got emotional. It was the only time I've ever seen these two men, you know, bond over something, kind of. Mm-hmm. They both had the same, emotions over that. So I'm kind of using that message to go around Connecticut and maybe bring people together. So that's what I can do as a state senator.
Okay, we'll see if you're able to do it, JT. Thank you so much for taking the time to join us.